Hello everyone, in this lab we will see inter-VLAN configuration. So for realization of inter-VLAN configuration using layer 2 switch, first we will take one layer 2 switch. So we will go to switch, we will take one 2960 switch and we will take few end devices such as PC. So we will take 4 PCs. The main task of this inter-VLAN configuration lab is to communicate between two virtual LANs. Okay, so we will take a practical example where suppose we are taking consideration of any institute where two labs are there. One is VLSI lab, another one is optical lab, and suppose this one is a VLSI lab. Okay, so in VLSI lab, suppose we are taking two computers and we are taking second one, that is optical lab. So suppose this one is an optical lab and there also two computers are there. Okay, for practical purpose or for realization, we are taking only consideration of two computers. There can be like 50-40 computers also, but we are taking two computers for realization of communication between those two VLANs. Using layer 2 and layer 3 switches. Okay, so the first thing what we will do is we will define two virtual LANs. Okay, those two virtual LANs we will name it as VLAN 10, and for this VLAN 10 is basically this pink color we are defining as a VLSI lab. So this is basically a VLSI lab, and for this VLAN number 10 we are defining IP address, private IP address of 192.168.10.0 network. Okay, the same thing we will do for this optical communication lab also, and in place of 10 we will name it as VLAN number 20, and this is optical lab. Okay, and the IP address or the network we will take 192.168.20.0. Okay, so you can see here that these two networks are different, 192.168.10, this one, and this is 192.168.20. In the next step, we will connect these computers or these end devices to this switch. So for connection, we will take copper straight through cable because these are two different layer devices. This is layer 7 device and this is layer 2 device. Okay, and like there are 24 fast Ethernet ports are there. So in these 24 fast Ethernet port, we will divide some in virtual LAN number 10 and some in virtual LAN number 20. So from 1 to 4 or 1 to 5 we will categorize in virtual LAN number 10. Okay, and from 20 to 24 we will categorize in virtual LAN number 20. Okay, so we want this one in VLAN number 10, so we will connect this from 20 from 2 and this one from 3. Okay, this one from 21 and this one from 22. After connection, we will go to this switch and configure our VLAN. So we will name two VLANs. We will create two VLANs. By default, there are five VLANs. Okay, these five VLANs are, the first one is default and other four are FDD, iDefault, Token Ring, okay, Telnet. So we will define two more VLANs inside this one. We will create it. Okay, so we will create VLAN number 10, and the name of the VLAN we will name it according to our lab, that is VLSI lab. Okay, and then we will create one more VLAN, that is VLAN number 20, and that is optical gap. So after adding, you can see that those two new VLANs are added now, and we need to go to all the ports wherever we are defining that this port is belonging to which VLAN. So by default, all the ports are belonging to VLAN number 1. So to define all the ports to different VLANs, basically we will go to all the ports. Suppose we want 1, 2, 5 in VLAN number 10. So we will go to port number 1. We will select that this is belonging to VLAN number 10. Similarly, we will go to port number 2 and we will define that this one is belonging to 10. And the same thing we will do with 3, 4 and 5 ports. So now you can see that port number 1, see here, okay, port number 1 is in VLAN 10, port number 2 is in VLAN 10, 3, 4 and 5, those are VLAN 10. Now we need to define port number 22, 24 in VLAN number 20. So we will go to port number 20 and we will define that it is in VLAN 20. Similarly, we will do for 21, 22, 23 and 24 ports. Okay, so now you can see that VLAN 24 port number 24 is in VLAN 20, 23, 22, 21 and 20, all are in VLAN number 20. So in this way we have created two VLANs, VLAN 10 and VLAN 20, and we have connected our network in the same manner, like this is connected with port number 2, this is connected with port number 3, this is with 21, this is with 22. Okay, now after defining virtual LANs, we can define the IP addresses of those end devices for their communication. Without assigning IP addresses, you can't be able to communicate. Okay, so we will go to this PC and we will define its IP address, which is from the network 192.168.10.0. So we will define 192.168.10.2. Okay. And default gateway we will define at the first address 192.168.1. The same thing we will do for this computer also. So we will go to this computer, we will go to desktop IP address, and we will give IP address of 192.168.10.3, subnet mask default one, we are not doing any subnetting, and we will define first address as the gateway address. After defining the IP addresses for these two computers, we will go to our optical lab and in a similar manner we will define IP address. So the IP address for this computer, we will define 192.168.20.2, and default gateway we will define as first address of that network. Similarly, we will go to another computer and we will define IP address 192.168.20.3 and first address of that network as a default gateway. So after this, we have defined the IP address for these two computers, and we have defined the virtual LAN in our layer 2 switch. Okay. So after this, you can be able to communicate between this computer and this computer, and you can be able to communicate between this computer and this computer. It means you can be able to communicate within the same virtual LAN. Okay, because this is the layer 2 switch and we are using two different networks. Okay. With the use of layer 2 switch, you can't be able to communicate between two different network. Okay, so we will realize this thing. So we'll select one packet, we'll send from one place to another place, like from this computer to this computer, and you can see it is successful. In the same manner, you can realize that communication between these two computers is also successful. Okay, but if you communicate between this VLAN to this VLAN, it will be failed. Like I'm communicating from here to here, and you can see here it is. Now we will see how we can communicate between these two labs or these two virtual LANs. So for communication between the two virtual LANs, basically you need one layer 3 switch or multi-layer switch or a router. So communication with the help of router we have already seen in previous labs or previous videos. In this video we will see the communication between two virtual LANs using a multi-layer switch. So we will select 3560 24 port multi-layer switch, and in that multi-layer switch also we need to define a path, define two paths, one for communication of this virtual LAN to this multi-layer switch and another path for communication of this virtual LAN to this multi-layer switch. Then only we can transmit data from one virtual LAN to another virtual LAN. Okay, so let's say in these 24 ports we are defining port 1 and port 2 to two different VLANs. By default all the things are there with VLAN number 1. So in this multi-layer switch also I am creating two VLANs, one with the VLAN number 10 and VLAN name we will name it as same, VLSI_lab, and second VLAN we will create as 20, that is optical lab. Okay, so now we have two different VLANs, and if I want to configure port number 1 as a VLAN number 10, so we will go to port number 1 and we will define that it is in VLAN number 10, and we will in a similar manner we will go to port number 2 and we will define that it is there with the VLAN number 20. Okay, after this we need to define the IP addresses of those two VLANs, and the IP addresses of those two VLANs are basically the default gateway of this VLSI lab or VLAN number 10 and the default gateway or gateway whatever we have given to this VLAN number 20. So first we will connect. So suppose we want to connect to this port number 1. Since we know that this port number 1 we have defined at VLAN number 10, so we will connect it with VLAN number 10, and VLAN number 10 range is 1 to 5. Okay, so let's say we are connecting this one with 1. Second wire we will take and we will connect it with port number 2, because this port number 2 is with VLAN number 20, and this switch port number 20 to 24 are there with VLAN number 20. So we will connect this to port number 20, let's say. Okay, so in this way what we have done is we have created a path from VLAN 10 through this switch to this multi-layer switch through this wire, and we have created another path from this optical lab through this switch to this multi-layer switch, okay, through this wire. Okay, so these colors will give you an idea that this is one way of communication, this is another way of communication, and here you need to define the IP addresses of these two ports as a default gateway of these two networks. So again, we will go to this switch and we will go to command mode. Exit from all other configuration. Okay, so now we are there in inside configure terminal mode. Inside configuration terminal mode, I will write IP routing. And then I will assign that where I want to give IP address, so for that one, first I need to go to interface, that is VLAN. First I am giving IP address for VLAN number 10, so I need to go to interface VLAN 10. And after going to interface VLAN 10, I can see that its status is now changed to up. And we can define IP address by writing command like IP address, that is 192.168.10.first address. Okay, we have defined the gateway address of those devices as the first address. Then subnet mask 255.255.255.0. After this, we need to define the IP address for VLAN 20 also in the same manner. So we will write IP address. First we will go to interface VLAN 20 and then we will write an IP address for this 20, that is 20.1, and subnet mask will be 255.255.255.0. And if you want to visualize all those things, you can visualize this by writing a command show IP interface and in a brief manner. So I will write brief. Okay, so here you can see that my fast Ethernet 1 and fast Ethernet 2, these two are in up status. Okay, and in the bottom I will get that VLAN number 10 having the IP address of this, VLAN number 20 having the IP address of this. Okay, that is by default gateway of all the end devices connected under VLAN number 10 and under VLAN number 20 respectively. So in this way, we have set up a network using multi-layer switch so that we can be able to communicate between two virtual nets. Okay, so now we will try this. We will communicate from one PC of VLAN number 10 to another PC of VLAN number 20, and we can see that it is successful now. Previously, without the help of this multi-layer switch, we can't be able to communicate between VLAN number 10 and VLAN number 20. Or in other words, we can say that we can't be able to communicate between VLSI lab and optical lab. And now using this multi-layer switch, we can be able to communicate between the two end devices from the different lab. Okay, so you can see that this is successful now. And the communication inside lab is by default successful because this communication is due to this switch. Okay, no need of this switch if you want to communicate within the lab. So this is successful. If you want to communicate between this PC to this PC, that is also successful. So in this way, in this video, we have seen that we can communicate between two virtual LANs with the help of one multi-layer switch or layer 3 switch. And the communication between two virtual LANs is not possible with the help of layer 2 switch, which we have already seen in previous videos. So in the next video, we will see one more case where we are using two switches. And under those two switches, we will create VLAN number 10 and VLAN number 20. And we will see how we can communicate in that scenario. Thank you.